I am honored to welcome you to the Osaka International School of Kwansei Gakuin's Class of 2018 graduation ceremony. The 26 seniors that will be on stage tonight are the largest graduating class in the history of the school. When the last senior receives their diploma during the ceremony, OIS will have had a total of 401 graduates. This is quite a long way from the first graduating class of 1993, with only one senior receiving his diploma. This class is special for more reasons than its size, however. They truly lived up to our mission of informed, caring, and creative. They excelled in the classroom with high scores on SAT exams, report cards, and hopefully their IB exams. Half of them will be matriculating in universities ranked in the top 200 in the QS World Rankings, and they will be studying in 8 different countries. They will be studying many different fields, ranging from anthropology to zoology. They were creative. It was very special to see the 10 seniors to perform at the university at their final concert last week. And it was wonderful to have the 5 seniors who had such a beautiful DP visual arts exhibition in April. They were also caring. The class raised over 1 million yen for the SOIS School of Hope in Cambodia. And they traveled there last year to restore electricity to the school and purchase computers for the students. I think most importantly are the type of young adults they have become. They are a tight-knit class and really support each other. Sola and Mia have spent all 14 years of their schooling here, and many of them have been together for a long time. They also welcome many new students in the high school, including Max from the Global Futures Program, and Meg, Elena, Nanami, and Natsumi from SIS. They have been ideal role models for all the students at OIS. A final thought before I introduce the MCs tonight. I was looking through their records yesterday, and I noticed that this will be the last class with students born in the last century, in 1999. With medical science and health and nutrition advancing and living in Japan for at least several years of their lives, I bet a good number of them will live to see the year 2100. Just imagine that, living in 3 different centuries. I'll let you ponder that as we celebrate their graduation tonight. It is my pleasure to introduce the hosts of the ceremony, the grade 12 homeroom advisors, Mr. David Algy and Mr. Stephen Frater. Thank you.
Thank you, Mr. Kralovic. Now, it's with our great pleasure that we introduce to you the graduating class of 2018.
Ami Eldridge.
Get back home. Once there was a way to get back home. Sleep, pretty darling, do not cry.
Yuto Baba.
Kaya Freeze.
What am I gonna say? When you make me feel this way, I just and it starts in my toes, makes me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me
Takumi Hathan.
Leola Hara.
Misaki Inokuchi. Christoph Holstein.
Rina Kawamura.
Iwamida.
Freya Kerwin.
Sola Lutringer.
Leo Sakamoto.
Mia Lewis.
Nasami Nagasaka.
Joseph Sheena.
Meg Nakagawa.
Max Sharp.
Manon Rabi.
Mitsuki Takizawa.
Yuki Sutton.
Evan Tsubaki.
Shoko Yamaji.
Hana Yasuda.
Mark Yamamoto.
Nicole Yu. So, ladies and gentlemen, we present to you the graduating class of 2018. Thank you.
In keeping with the tradition at OIS, the senior class has selected a speaker for their commencement address. This year's class has chosen Mr. McGill.
Heads of school, faculty, family and friends, the graduating class. There were once two men advanced in years sharing a small room on the top floor of a hospital building. The room was dominated by a large window. The older of the two occupied the bed adjacent to the window, while the other lay in the shadows in the corner, for he was by far the sicker of the two. Occasionally, the one next the window would raise himself and peer out, then slump back exhausted, but with a smile on his face. The two rarely spoke. But one day, as the man peered out, the other asked what he saw. He described an autumn scene, the park and lake bathed in amber sunlight, the maples and aspens in vibrant colours, the visitors happy to live in a world where there were Octobers. And the other hung on his words and fancied himself there. And the season changed. The park now lay under the big snow, and the lake was a sheet of ice. The maple and the aspen were bare, and the northern wind tore bitterly at the visitors. And as the man narrated these scenes, the nurse would sometimes enter, look from the window, and smile knowingly. And so it continued. Winter became spring and spring summer. And then, with that suddenness which always surprises, the man next to the window died. The other felt the loss keenly and asked if he might move by the window. Weak though he was, he raised himself and peered out and was transfixed. For there before him was neither lake nor trees nor visitors, but only a crumbling concrete edifice, its sagging roof rank with the pools of stagnant water. He slumped back in disappointment and turned his face to the wall. He spoke no more to the nurse, for had she not been complicit in this fiction? Noting his silence, she inquired as to its cause. He asked why the man had so deceased him, to which the nurse replied, "You are mistaken. He did not deceive you. He gave you the greatest gift he had. He gave you his imagination." For all of you on stage this evening, school life began with stories. Stories which transported you to other places. You read or were read stories that permitted you to imagine the world through the eyes of others, the author, and by extension, the characters and scenes the author creates. And in doing so, you learn that language exists not merely to depict the actual, but also to liberate the imagination. In middle and high, this continued. We asked you to see the world through characters as diverse as Guy Montag, Scout Finch, Daisy Bunting, Desdemona, and Billy Pilgrim, in settings as varied as the Caribbean, rural Kentucky, medieval Scotland, wartime Dresden, and the unnamed streets of Harajuku. In grade 8, we read Julius Caesar together and traveled back to ancient Rome. I asked you to commit a speech to memory and deliver it before class, fully costumed in the character of Caesar or Brutus or Antony. Leo asked me, what was the point of doing this? But as Leo always asked that kind of question, we just ignored him. I told you to imagine you were really there in the forum, to step into the shoes of the character. This was difficult for all of you, but especially for Christoph, who already took a size 16 shoe at that time. Some of you wanted to wear a beard, and here Christoph had the advantage, having already had one since kindergarten. Anna chose as her pair of shoes a pair of electric pink Nike sneakers, the first time such footwear had been seen in ancient Rome. And Sola, for some reason known to him, wore a blue Manchester City shirt under his toga. Joe decided to deliver his speech in the high macho style, slashing the air with strange Roman salutes each time he shouted the name Caesar. Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears. I come to bury Caesar, not to praise him. The evil that men do lives after them. The good is oft interred with their bones. So let it be with Caesar. Each of you imagined it in your own way. Why then have we asked you to see the world through the eyes of so many others? Earlier this year, I read The Better Angels of Our Nature by Steven Pinker. He puts forward the argument that contrary to popular belief, life is actually getting better in virtually every regard, and that life has become less rather than more violent over the centuries. One reason, he claims, is the increase of literacy spurred by the invention of the printing press. Literacy in turn promotes empathy, the ability to see other people's emotions, coupled with the ability to imagine what someone else might be thinking or feeling. Where humans once inhabited their own insular world, family, clan, tribe, nation, through literature they were now able to live in different times, geographical locations, and social realities. Where once empathy depended on shared values, I treat you justly because you are like me, it could now embrace others outside the immediate group. Dickens showed empathy towards the vulnerable by creating such characters as Oliver Twist, Tiny Tim, and Little Dorrit, and in turn engendered empathy in his reading public for these characters. The empathy of the individual was transposed into the popular imagination, which translated into social change, into making the world a better place. For in fiction, we encounter those who inhabit circumstances beyond the bounds of our comfort and experience. In one day in the life of Ivan Denisovich, we spend from reveille to lights out with the protagonist Shukov, sentenced to 10 years in a Stalin gulag for a crime he never committed. We see the terror and monotony of the camp, the arbitrary violence, the life of inmates who lick out the balls of others. As we read the final paragraph, we get a sense of what Shukov meant by a happy day. He'd had many strokes of luck that day. They hadn't put him in the cells. They hadn't sent his squad to the settlement. He'd swiped a bowl of kasha at dinner. He'd smuggled that bit of hacksaw blade through. He'd bought that tobacco. And he hadn't fallen ill. Almost a happy day. But as he struggles to survive in temperatures of minus 17, Shukov asks us, the reader, a crucial question. How can you expect a man who's warm to understand one who's cold? And the answer is, of course you can't. No more than you can expect anyone to fully comprehend the anguish of Seth, the female protagonist of Toni Morrison's novel Beloved, who as a mother is reduced to killing her children rather than have them return to a life of slavery. We cannot fully understand them, but that does not mean we mustn't try. Empathy itself is morally neutral. We don't have to sympathize with the character, we don't have to like them or agree with them. When we read To Kill a Mockingbird, we were disgusted by Bob Yule, who mocked all that was decent in society, terrorizing children, and so lying so a man might die. Yet I suspect none of us was jubilant when he finally fell on his own knife, no doubt due to the narrative skill of Harper Lee, who conveys that even a character as despicable as Bob Yule was a victim of the mores and attitudes that governed Alabama in the 1930s. Perhaps Atticus's words to Scout: "You never really understand a person until you consider things from his point of view, until you climb into his skin and walk around in it," extend equally to Bob Yule as to anyone else. For the characters we meet in literature are nuanced and face complex moral dilemmas. We may not condone Seth's course of action in Beloved. We might not pardon Othello's decision to kill his wife as a solution to eliminating the sources of evil in the world. But at least we can acknowledge the dilemmas they face are complex and imbued with moral ambiguity. And in so doing, perhaps it can make us that little more tolerant, more forgiving, less quick to rush to judgment. There, but for the grace of God, go I. For if we lack empathy, if we do not try and imagine the stories of others, perhaps we may begin to see them as fundamentally different from ourselves. And if we are not very careful, we can end up dehumanizing them. And therein lies the greatest danger. The novelist Ian McEwan, writing shortly after the 9/11 attack, said, "Imagining what it is like to be someone other than yourself is the core of our humanity. The hijackers use fanatical certainty to purge themselves of the instinct for empathy. Among their crimes was a failure of the imagination." An important chapter closes in the story of our graduates this evening, a story which for some of you began in kindergarten and others more recently. We hope that your time at OIS has given you a window on the world through which you have been able to liberate your imaginations, to see new vistas and encounter different people. Remember that the imagination is always a work in progress. It does not end this evening. So keep reading those stories, reciting those lines from Julius Caesar, and keep looking through that window. There will be times when you will see that crumbling edifice with its stagnant pools of water, and you will be disappointed and want to turn your face to the wall. But we are confident you will look again to see past that which inhibits your view and imagine a better world. Thank you very much. My pleasure to welcome our student representatives, Sola and Mia, to the podium.
I am Mia Lewis.
Hi, I'm Sola Luchenger.
And today we will be making a speech representing the graduating class of 2018.
So Mia, didn't you find it hard to summarize 14 years into 10 minutes for this speech?
Yeah, Sola, it was. And we really wanted to avoid the typical planned conversation format people tend to use for graduation speeches.
You mean like what we're doing now?
Yeah.
So today we'll be looking back at some of the most memorable events over the years.
There were countless events in elementary, including Sports Day, celebrating 100 days of school, Osaka Olympics, and field trips. But the exhibition in grade 5 was our first long-term academic project, where we tackled broad topics including child abuse, the influence of violent video games, drugs, and endangered animals, which has definitely left an impact on all of us. Working in groups for months to create a detailed presentation was a huge achievement for 12-year-olds.
But of course, the most exciting event during elementary was our graduation ceremony in grade 5. Some parents may remember coming to watch our play, where we changed the gender roles of classic fairy tales and gave alternative endings where everything went wrong. Even though we had some trouble on the day where our Cinderella Leo was sick, Hideki quickly stood up for Leo, where he had to act out a fight scene with our Prince Charming, Freya. Hopefully those disastrous endings are not waiting for us in the future.
In high school, all the students have the opportunity to choose a spring camp to participate in. But for grades 6 through 8, we all went to the same camps for 3 days. Many of us remember the Sangari camp in 6th grade, where we were split into groups and completed activities in the forests and surrounding facilities. Some of us may even have shed a few tears when we told scary stories around a fire at night. Even worse, we had to walk through the forest in complete darkness, and for those who are weak-hearted, it was a complete night of terror.
And of course, at the service trip that everyone here will remember, each year, since elementary, we raise money at events such as Drop Anything and Read and school festivals at the end. And at the end, our class was successful in raising 1 million yen for the school in Cambodia that our community helped build, the SOIS School of Hope. Not only did we financially aid the school, we traveled there last year. We interacted with the children there, we shared Japanese culture, and they taught us traditional games and other activities they do in Cambodia as well. In our free time, some people got henna tattoos and explored the markets, while others decided to venture out a bit and try some street food, including tarantula. All in all, our service trip was a fruitful experience, and as well as helping us meet part of the school's mission of contributing to the global community, it also brought all of us closer together as a class.
Although it was a shame to get to know everyone and then realize we only had 1 year left together, the stronger bond was definitely a key factor in surviving the IB program as a class. And in that class, there are so many talented and amazing people. I'm already excited to see what people will be doing this time next year in 5, 10, or even 15 years. Speaking of our classmates, let's think of all the people who have come and gone. Here at OIS, each student has an ID number. Ours all start with 18 because we're the graduating class of 2018. The reason us two are doing this speech is because we have the lowest ID numbers. That means that we've been here for the longest time. My number is 182003.
And mine is 182004.
Meg's is 182064, and she was the last person to join our class. Rina and Freya have 2 numbers because they left and came back. But altogether, we have had 61 people come through our class. A couple of others who have been with us since the beginning are here today, but sitting out there somewhere that I can't see right now. Oh. But Aiden's ID is 182002 and has also been here with us from the beginning, and Ray with 182011.
And within the 26, we can't help but mention the achievements and talents our classmates have. We have some amazing artists such as Anna, Nicole, and Shoko, and musicians such as Yuki and Leo in the graduating class this year. We even have a class DJ, DJ Kriegel.
Our class also has outstanding athletes that took parts in Sabre soccer, which is Ami and Evan, basketball, Masami and Mark, and cross country, including Yuto and Leola.
We also have great writers, such as Kaya, Freya, Hannah, Manon, and Meg, that constantly contribute to this class's uniqueness.
Another contribution to this class that cannot be ignored are the 3 students from SIS who are sitting in the 2nd row, and they had to take IB classes while adhering to SIS requirements, and they are Natsumi, Nanami, and Elena.
As most of the students in OIS know, there's a space outside this theater where 2 of our class breakdancers, Joseph and Mitsuki, always practice. B-boy crow and B-boy teent.
In grade 9 and grade 11, 2 new guys from the UK, Takumi and Max, joined our class and taught us everything we needed to know about British slang.
With 6 album releases and numerous hit singles, this physics trio, Rina, Misaki, and Keia, dominated the music industry and the OIS science department. Give it up for the little DuPonts.
The clearest in our memories are the 2 tough years of constant work in the DP program. Although with TOK, internal assessments, extended essay, and of course exams, it wasn't an easy ride and definitely full of stress. But with the combined personalities of our class, our work has paid off and we are able to graduate with confidence and excitement.
And that journey wouldn't be complete without the teachers who have supported us for so long.
Some teachers have been here for the whole 14 years, such as Miss Mori, Miss Entwistle, Osako Sensei, and Miss Sweet, who even ended up teaching some students for Japanese ab initio in the IB.
Although many of our elementary teachers, such as Mr. Bonifoy, Ms. Lindley, and Mr. Barrett, are not here anymore, they gave us amazing experiences, memories to take on into middle and high school.
Many of our middle school teachers have supported us through the IB program as well, including Ms. Cheney for History, TOK, and EE, Mr. Algie and Mr. Summer for English, and Mr. Brittman for Mathematics. それから遠藤先生、漢字ができない私たちをずっと支えてきてくださってありがとうございます。おかげで12年までには成長することができたと思います。
6年生の広告小学校から IB の授業まで本当にお世話になりました。And of course to our IB teachers and our homeroom teachers, Mr. Fader and Mr. Algie, thank you for all your work, especially for the past 2 years. None of us would have made it this far without your constant support and availability for us at all times.
Collectively as a class, we would once again like to thank all the teachers and staff here at school, our parents, other students and friends who have supported us for all these years. Please don't hesitate to stop now.
Thank you.
Thank you, class of 2018, for your heartfelt words. And now, to announce the awards recipients, I wish to welcome to the stage the principal of Osaka International School, Mr. Kurt Mecklem, and the head of Osaka International School, Mr. Bill Kralovic.
Good evening. This year we have one award to present during the ceremony, the Osaka Governor's Award. This award is presented to a student who has bridged cultures successfully in positive ways, has good grades, has shown responsibility, and has been a model for what we expect an OIS student to be. Our award winner fits all of these criteria, and the teachers wanted to recognize her because her leadership and contributions do not always go noticed. She has a quiet leadership style that allows others to contribute and work toward team goals. She is humble, extremely intelligent, and driven. On a weekly basis for years, she has selflessly completed the paper recycling for the school, contributing to a positive environmental impact while providing a very useful service for her community. She has participated in numerous other extracurricular responsibilities, including volunteering at Ronald McDonald House. Her grasp of global issues goes beyond a superficial action and is demonstrated by her ongoing commitment to areas of action, including environmental and social responsibility. It is for those reasons that her teachers have chosen to recognize Freya Kirwan with the Osaka Governor's Award. Congratulations. It's now our pleasure to award the graduating class of 2018 their individual diplomas. Yuto Baba.
Seven years ago, my brother. Last year, my father. And today, I will be leaving an OIS. OIS has been like a home to me, and I'm thankful for the memories I've made here since kindergarten.
まず、家族のみんな、本当に今までありがとうございました。この学校に通えた僕は幸せ者です。ごめんなさいですね。そして遠藤先生、先生のご指導なしではここまで来ることができませんでした。本当に10年はすごくつらかったけど、遠藤先生のおかげでここまで頑張りました。本当にありがとうございました。
Oh my god, so sorry. Finally, I want to thank my class and the people I met in ASB, swimming, cross country, and student council. See you guys someday, and thanks for all the great memories. Thank you.
Ami Eldridge.
あっという間に OIS での2年間が過ぎました。Thank you to my classmates in the school for making me feel so welcome. I also want to thank my class for teaching me to become a caring and kinder person. This school helped me broaden my horizons, especially thanks to Mr. Sekum. You've taught me so much useless knowledge. Thanks. I've really enjoyed soccer here. Coaching the middle school girls, placing WJA and NYSA 2 years in a row were all experiences I will never forget. So thank you, Mr. Frater, for being such a good coach and mentor. そしてマミ、いつも朝早くから美味しいお弁当作ってくれてありがとう。And thank you, Daddy, for not once through my whole school life pressuring me about my grades. It allowed me to develop in my own way. Most of all, I'd like to thank my family for trusting me to make my own decisions. Thank you.
Kaya Fries.
I've never been this nervous for a speech before, and that's because all of you sitting before and behind me are people who have touched me in one way or another, especially my mom and dad, who work hard to give me all these opportunities. I hope you're all proud of the person I am today. If not, I'm here to remind you of the Kaya who was dippa with the unibrow and too shy to speak to anyone. I think I only talked to Joe once in all of grade 7. Let me emphasize, there's a lot to be thankful for and a lot to be proud of. I'm especially proud to be graduating with all of you. 今までありがとうございました。
Leola Hara.
High school was tough for me. Sometimes it felt like a never-ending tunnel, and I never thought I would get through. And yet, here I am today, alive and kicking. Thank you to all my teachers who put up with my never-ending tears. Thank you to my amazing classmates for accepting me for who I am. Thank you to the running club for providing me with a second home. Thank you, Reina, for being my sister. I don't know how you do it. But most of all, Papa, Mama, arigato. I am beyond blessed to have you as my parents. Thank you for never, ever giving up on me. Thank you, everyone who made this possible.
Takumi Harthan.
My time at this school has truly been an unforgettable experience. I'd like to thank my parents for supporting me the whole time and giving me the opportunity to come here, despite shoving me in the dorm during the IB. Despite this, I can't express how grateful I am towards the guys at the dorm. They made me feel right at home and helped me with everything from cooking to extreme procrastination when it mattered the most. I would also like to thank my close friends and classmates for their many great memories that I'll continue to cherish for the rest of my life. Thanks, guys. It's been a lot of fun.
Christoph Holstein.
I have too many people to thank in 30 seconds. I want to first thank my parents for supporting me for the last 18 years, as well as dealing with several IB-related mental breakdowns I had for the last 2 years. I want to thank Mr. McGill, who was my favorite teacher in OIS. He is also responsible for not only making me interested in history, but also for saving my EE by always keeping me on track. I also want to thank Ms. Endo. Sengari Camp で夜中に緊急搬送された時に付き添ってもらったことは一生忘れません。Lastly, I want to thank my classmates for being one of the most trustworthy and fun people to hang out with. I know I'll be meeting with you guys again after today, so I'll see you guys again soon. Thank you.
Kea Iwamida.
My life as an OI student is finally ending after 7 years. I'm looking forward to starting a new life at a country that I've never been to. But on the other hand, I will have to leave my home, my family, my friends, and everything that I'm used to. I know that we're all going to be separated, but I hope we can see each other again someday in the future as adults.
これから遠い国で暮らすことになりますが、支えてくれた人たちへいつか僕から恩返しができればいいなと、できるように帰ってこられたらいいなと思います。
Thanks everyone and see you again.
Misaki Inokuchi.
I've only had the pleasure to know most of my classmates for just shy of 2 years. In that short time, I've had the most memorable experiences with the most memorable people. To my classmates who answered my homework questions late at night, crammed for a test with me the period before, or came to eat Indian with me after school way too many times, I thank you for your company and help and wish you best in your future endeavors. To my family, I will always appreciate the love and care you've shown for me, and I thank you for your continued support in the next 4 years as well. Thank you.
Rina Kawamura.
I'm so excited to be graduating high school, and I want to say a few words of gratitude because I couldn't have done it alone. First of all, お母さん、18年間厳しく育ててくれてありがとうございます。お父さん、いつも優しくリナのことを見守っていてくれてありがとうございます。二人には言い切れないほど感謝しています。Also, thank you to all my teachers that have taught me during the past 2 years and helped me grow academically. And finally, to my classmates, I have taken inspiration from so many of you during the past 2 years in developing my character and the person that I am. So thank you for always showing me love and support, and I will miss you all very much.
Anna Kim.
As much as I am sad to leave this school, I am very proud of our grade for making it this far. Thank you all so much for the great memories. Ms. Espy, thank you so much for constantly providing us with cheesecakes and pizzas and being so organized with our schedule. I seriously couldn't have done it without you. Leo, thank you for making my high school life so memorable. Because of you, I laughed every day and cried when you left for soccer tournaments. 그리고 마지막에 엄마 아빠
그동안 나를 위해서 잠깐만. 그동안 나를 위해서 매일매일 열심히 일하러 나가고 학교까지 데려다주고 도시락 사줘서 너무 감사합니다. 너무너무 감사하고 사랑합니다.
프레야 키어원.
When OIS ends, I'd like to express my endless thanks to my friends, family, teachers, and everyone else who has supported me throughout my time here and whom I will dearly miss. I would like to wish all my classmates great success as we all go out into the world. Wherever our paths may lead, I know we will never forget our time in OIS. And so, with endless possibilities before the class of 2018, I wish you all a fond farewell.
Sola Lutringer.
Fourteen years ago, I came to OIS without knowing a single word in English. But with the support of my family, teachers, and friends, I grew, not only as a student, but as a teacher. And I'll forever be grateful for that. I remember the memories I made on this stage, the talent shows in kindergarten, to recitals in high school. These memories, along with the ones I made outside this theater, are what made me who I am today, and I'm thankful to my classmates and also my lifelong friends I made through sports and music for being part of them. Finally, thank you, Mom, Dad, and Grandma. 立派な大人になっていきます。
Mia Lewis.
Hello. So it's finally my turn to stand up here and graduate. It's been a long journey, and although it's a bit of a cliche, I don't regret a single second. Something close to my heart tonight is being able to graduate in this theater, where I practically spent my childhood, mainly through ASP, creating everlasting friendships and memories. Saying goodbye after 14 years isn't easy, but my experience here has me ready to move full steam ahead. And if, by any chance, you happen to miss me, I'm sure a few Lewis family members will be hanging around. Thank you.
Masami Nagasaka.
To Japan, I spent my whole life in a very conservative all-girls school. OIS is a completely different world, which made me a much more open-minded person. I'm thankful. Daddy. いい生活をできるようにいろいろなsacrifices してくれてありがとう。まあ、for telling me you love me and that you're proud of me, even though I'm only ordinary, thank you. My siblings for giving me a reason to smile every day. Thank you. And to God for blessing me with so many amazing people. Thank you. I will never forget the friends and memories I made here. OYS, arigatou gozaimashita.
Meg Nakagawa.
Amidst the stress of IB and being a teenager, it's incredibly easy to forget how blessed and privileged we are with the lives we have. And now, as we graduate, I believe that it is our responsibility to step out in the world with our knowledge and capabilities and help those who are less fortunate than us. I'm incredibly grateful for my time here at SOIS, the unconditional love I've received from my parents, and most importantly, for the best siblings in the world, Emma and Kenkin. You two make my world so much brighter, and I love you more than anything. Thank you.
Manon Robbie.
There's really so much I'd like to say, but here it is in 30 seconds. I am so grateful, and I've learned so much, and have made friendships that I hope will last a lifetime. And how lucky I am to be able to say that. And of course, I'm infinitely grateful for my parents who have supported me my entire life. I hope I can make you proud with the life that I will lead. And finally, I just want to say congratulations to my class. We are capable of greatness, and I wish nothing but happiness for you all. Thank you.
Leo Sakamoto.
First and foremost, I want to thank my parents for giving me the opportunity to attend OIS, and onegai shimasu for a few more years. I'd also like to give credit to my dogs, Nicholas and Vivian, for always being so sweet, undoubtedly the cutest dogs in our class. Big thanks to all my teachers and classmates who taught me many valuable lessons and inspired me over the years, and Anna for always supporting me, like when you wrote down my whole solo while I was busy practicing for our last concert just a few days ago. Mr. V, if you're around, your Sakamoto dynasty has finally come to an end. Hope you don't miss us too much. And finally, to all those in strings and soccer, being able to lead you guys has truly been an honor. I love you guys, and I wish you the best of luck in the future. Thank you.
Max Sharp.
It's been a short 2 years at OIS. I've been through some ups and downs. I've been in trouble a few times, but I hope I've made myself a good addition to the class and the school as a whole. Although I'm a relatively new student, I've made some of the best friends I ever could hope for. I never really felt like an outsider. As the first time I ever came to this school, my very first day, I got called Ed Sheeran, just like I did back in Wales. I'm really grateful that we all made it through this seemingly endless tunnel together. And Mum, I can't really see you, but you've always been there for me. And sorry, one second. I'm so glad that it was you. I wouldn't want it any other way. Thanks, OIS. It's been a great one. OIS, no, minasan, arigatou gozaimashita.
Joseph Shina.
I'm Joseph Shina. Life is full of things that can make you go bald. In fourth grade, I got a bald spot from smashing into a table in the cafeteria. In seventh grade, I started doing head spins and went even more bald. I also probably lost some hair during my IB years, so now I ask myself, how in the world do I still have hair? Well, my answer is you. Mom, Dad, EJ, Kaya, friends, teachers. Thanks to you, I was able to get through all the hard times. And so I hope that when the time comes for me to say farewell to my last piece of hair, each and every one of you are still there by my side. Thank you, everyone. I see you today.
Yuki Sutton.
I thank you one and all, the ones who thought I'd fall, who taught me how to fail, who helped me to prevail. I'm standing here today, 'cause you helped me find my way. Thank you, SOIS, for the countless opportunities on this stage that have made me who I am. I am so grateful to my teachers, fellow students, and their parents who have supported me throughout these past 6 years. Finally, my parents have stopped everything to ensure my success. Despite this, they're letting me become an actor. This is one of the last professions any parent wants to see their kid pursue. Because we don't make money. But I'm so lucky because they're trusting me with the decision that I've made. You both are the reason why I'm so privileged to go out into the world to see what it has to offer me. Kansha shtimas.
Mitsuki Takazawa.
From friends, family, and teachers who helped me get to where I am today. I want to start out by saying thank you to all and my friends and family for helping me every step of the way. It has been a challenging yet amazing journey, and one I and my fellow class of 2018 members will most likely never forget. We all have different career choices, and but we're all bound by the same common cause. And that is to graduate. Thank you.
Evan Tsubaki.
My time here at OAS has been much more academically challenging than I was used to. But I'm grateful that my parents gave me the opportunity to attend a school like OAS. Thank you to my family for supporting me through school, and thank you to my teachers for going above and beyond to prepare me not only for exams, but for my life ahead. I'll miss the friends I've made here as I move forward in life, and I hope to meet many of you again. Thank you, everyone, for the great memories.
Shoko Yamaji.
My 9 years in OIS have been a whirlwind. I have made priceless memories and friends, met teachers who have supported me through thick and thin. I feel so lucky and grateful to have spent half of my life with my classmates. It has truly been an amazing ride, and although it is ending, I will always hold the memories I have with all of you close to my heart. Finally, and most importantly, I would not have been able to stand here today without the unconditional love and support from my parents, who I cannot thank them enough. Thank you, everyone, and let the new chapters begin.
Mark Yamamoto.
I'll be the first to admit that my high school career was not perfect. The ups throughout my journey reminded me why life is good, but more importantly, the downs reminded me how and why it is necessary to grow as a person. Thank you to all of my teachers, coaches, advisors, Minoa International Church, youth group, all of my awesome friends, and girlfriend Kiana, who all impacted me so greatly. I also want to thank Mitsuhashi Sensei, a teacher, student council advisor, but also mentor, who picked me up during my most difficult stage. Around 1 year ago, I promised to stand up here today and thank you, so here I am. And of course, thank you to my family for everything. Mom, Dad, Hannah, you always guided me to not simply do what I want, but what is right. Ojii-chan e, kyou no tame ni Amerika kara kite hontou ni arigatou gozaimasu. So thank you, everyone. Nanto, happy happy de jinsei o sugoshitai to omoimasu.
Hana Yasuda.
It feels weird standing up here today because I thought that we would magically be stuck here somehow in this school forever. I love being a part of this class of 2018, and thank you for accepting me for who I am. そして、家族のみんな。今日は来てくれてありがとう。いつも一番近くで応援してくれて、本当に感謝しています。そしてママ、ママは私の一番の親友で、世界で一番の母親です。言葉にできないくらい感謝しています。So thanks for all the precious memories, and I hope to see you all soon. Thank you.
Nicole Yu.
Mom, Appa, I can't see you right now, but thank you for always being there. Mediums, Linz, I'll miss you guys. Whenever you guys come back to LA, me and Nelly will be waiting for you. To everyone sitting behind me, thank you for putting up with me even though I didn't talk through 10th grade. It's been a great 2 years, and I'm extremely grateful for the friends I've made here. I'd also like to thank everyone who has helped me to get here, including those 9th graders who invade my house, Remy, Mena, the rest of Club JC,and all of our friends and family back home in LA.
Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the OIS class of 2018. Congratulations.
Along with the 26 OIS graduates now on stage,
Three SIS students also completed their IB diploma this May. The OIS class of 2018 would like to invite their fellow classmates to the stage to say a few words. Would Elena, Natsumi, and Nanami like to come up onto the stage, please?
Good evening. I'm Elena.
I'm Nanami.
And I'm Natsumi.
First of all, we would like to congratulate the class of 2018 for successfully graduating Osaka International School and completing the IBDP. I believe we three are the only ones who can truly understand the late nights, the early mornings, the stress and the struggle the past 2 years has brought upon us. But at the same time, we also feel the same relief and the sense of accomplishment they are feeling as they sit smiling behind us.
Although we each had our own struggles during the diploma program, we feel that it has been an extremely rewarding experience thanks to our classmates and all the teachers who supported us throughout the course. Even though we were only here for the final 2 years of their long journey in OIS, the class of 2018 was very accepting and made us feel comfortable from day one. We shared time in and out of class, which both meant a lot to us and hopefully brought the two schools together as a whole.
With a big class like this, that is kind, funny, smart, and excels in both academics and other activities, you guys continuously helped us when we were struggling, looked out for us, and made us laugh when IB was driving us crazy. I was always saved by my classmates when Mr. DuPont roasted us for not being able to solve problems we learned in kindergarten. It was a pleasure to study with such an amazing group of people. Thank you to the class of 2018 for being such a great class.
We would also like to thank the teachers in both of the schools for providing us with the opportunity to take IB from SIS. I have to admit that having to take PE classes with the ninth graders as a senior was a bit embarrassing, but thank you for making all this possible for us.
And to the teachers who supported us through the course, Endo-sensei, SIS から来たのに Japanese A のみんなと同じくらい漢字ができなくてびっくりさせました。葛藤は未だに怪しいですが、分析は漢字で書けるようになりました。ありがとうございます。最後にクラスのみんなへ。Thank you everyone for the love and support, and we wish you the very best at your next destination.
海外に旅行するときはみんな止めてね。We look forward to all the great things you will all bring to the world.
Thank you very much. ありがとうございました。
Thank you, Elena, Natsumi, and Nanami. We would like to take this opportunity to thank those who made the reception and the ceremony possible. To Mr. McGill, the Grade 11 homeroom teachers, and all of the Grade 11 students and parents. And finally, special thanks to Osako-sensei, Sakanaka-sensei, and the students helping with the lighting and the sound in the theatre tonight.
So finally, to the graduating class of 2018, we offer our congratulations and best wishes for the future. It's been a very great pleasure teaching you, and we look forward to following your achievements at college and beyond when you pursue your interests through what looks to be a very wide range of fields. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for coming and joining us this evening to celebrate with the graduating students. We would now like to conclude the ceremony, and we'd like to invite you to continue the celebrations with us in the cafeteria area and, if the weather holds off, the courtyard. Thank you very much indeed, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you.
feel down. Unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us. Sing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game. And together at the end of the day, we all say, when I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes. When I get older, I will be stronger. They'll call me freedom, just like a waving flag. And then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes back, and then it goes forward. Feel down, unify us, make us feel proud. In the streets our heads are lifting. As we lose our inhibition, celebration, it surrounds us. Every nation all around us. Singing forever young, singing songs underneath the sun. Let's rejoice in the beautiful game. And together at the end of the day, we all sing. Just like a waving flag. And then it goes back. And then it goes back. And then it goes back.
Thoughts in my toes, makes me crinkle my nose. Wherever it goes, I always know that you make me smile. Please stay for a while now, just take your time wherever you go. But what am I gonna say when you make me feel this way? I just starts in my chest. We'll be right back.
Thank you. mass and give it velocity.
Keep talking, whoa, keep talking.
Then you get momentum where P is equal to MV.
I love equations, oh, I love equations.
Another thing to know is momentum is conserved.
In every situation, even in a car collision. Momentum, go, 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 go.
F equals MA and impulse is F times V.
Momentum, oh, momentum.
Change in momentum equals impulse, see how it links.